morning, students. Today we are going to start the chapter aldehyde, ketone and carboxylic acids. But before I start the chapter, let me walk you through how to access the revision notes and the test series in our website. If you click on play6.com and go to practice, we have different packages available here, but since this session we are doing it for NEET Premium, let us go to NEET Premium. And here you are having test for different subjects, that is your physics, chemistry, biology, and a NEET full test. NEET full test will have two sections, one the test series which is prepared by the Play6 tutor, and the other section is past papers. And at the top you have the revision notes. If you click on revision notes, it opens in a new tab. And now let us start the session with our aldehyde, ketone and carboxylic acid. When we say aldehyde, what does it talk about? Actually, aldehydes are your carbonyl group which is bonded to carbon and hydrogen, and in ketone it is bonded to two carbon atoms. That's it. So when we say about your aldehyde, they are nothing but the functional isomers of each other. Aldehyde and ketone are functional isomers of each other. So it is very important to say that there are certain properties of your aldehyde as well as your ketone. But if we look at the structure, there are multiple bonds. Therefore, we could say that it will show addition reaction. When looking at the structure, when we could feel that there are multiple bonds there, we could conclude that it will show addition reaction. And also, it will show you nucleophilic addition reaction. It will be showing nucleophilic addition reaction with loss of water. Secondly, we can say that it will undergo reduction, and it can also undergo oxidation. So the basic is aldehyde and ketone. If we are talking about their strength, if the magnitude of your positive charge is more on carbon atom, then we could say that more readily it will show you nucleophilic addition reaction. So we could conclude that from all the members, if I say your formaldehyde will show this reaction more easily because it will not have any alkyl group, that is your electron releasing group is being present. So for example, if we say, if we try to compare your formaldehyde, ethanol and ketone, or we can say it as propanone, the order of their nucleophilic addition reaction will go in this. Your methanol will be more reactive based compared to your ethanol, and then you will have your ketone, that is propanone. So this would be the order of their nucleophilic addition reaction. And when we are saying the new chemical properties, of course we are discussing about your nucleophilic addition reaction, but there are possibility of your nucleophilic addition reaction with loss of water molecule, with the loss of water molecules. So if in this reaction, basically we say the reaction is going to occur, for example, we can say that the reaction is going to occur with ammonia and its derivatives. So there will be a loss of your water molecule from it. And if we say that the reaction of any of your aldehyde is going to take place with your hydroxyl amine, the product formed will be oxime. Like for example, I can take ethanol, CH3C bond H double bond O plus your NH2OH, and the product formed will be CH3CH and your NOH. This is called as oxime. So whenever an aldehyde is reacting with hydroxyl amine, you are saying that the product formed is your oxime. What happens when an aldehyde reacts with hydrazine? When an aldehyde reacts with hydrazine, it forms hydrazones. It forms hydrazones. So when we say ethanol, when it is reacting with ethanol plus hydrazine, when it is reacting, it gives you a product as hydrazones. It gives us a product as your hydrazones. In the same way, it can even react with your phenylhydrazine. So again, an ethanol with phenylhydrazine will give you phenylhydrazone. So there are multiple reactions which an aldehyde can go. It can react with semicarbide to give you semicarbazone. So there are different chemical properties of your aldehyde. And it is very important to say that it will undergo oxidation reaction. That is, aldehyde as well as ketone, on oxidation, it will give you carboxylic acid. But this will happen only in presence of your oxidizing agent like your nitric acid, potassium permanganate, or any of your in presence of the oxidizing agent. Hence, we could get a acid whenever your aldehyde and ketone are getting oxidized. But the condition applied here is aldehydes are even easily oxidized even with your mild oxidizing agent. They can be oxidized. But for the case of ketone, we always require a strong oxidizing agent. We always require a strong oxidizing agent. So for example, we can say, what are all the oxidizing agent we are using for aldehyde? Tollens reagent is considered as a mild oxidizing agent. So it is a solution. What is Tollens reagent? It is nothing but a solution of ammoniacal silver nitrate. And this Tollens reagent is used as an oxidizing agent in order to oxidize your aldehyde to carboxylic acid, but it is considered to be a mild oxidizing agent, and therefore we could say that it can also be used as a method, or it can be used as a process to test your aldehyde. We can also use the Felling solution test. That is, Felling solution is nothing but your, it is prepared by mixing equal amount of your Felling solution A and Felling solution B. So we can say that it is copper sulfate and your sodium potassium carbonate, which we also called it as your Rochelle salt. Rochelle salt. So we could say that even Felling solution, we can use it as a method in order to test the presence of an aldehyde. What happens when we use a Felling solution in aldehyde is color will change from blue to red, and this is basically, this reaction is not given by ketone. Hence, it is also a method which is being used in order to test the presence of an aldehyde. The third method which we can use is called as Benedict's test. It is nothing but an alkaline solution of cupric ion, alkaline solution of cupric ion complex with your citrate ion. So when we react aldehyde, the reaction will take place. That is, you will get a product of reddish brown. Reddish brown precipitate will be formed, whereas that particular test is not given by ketones. But if we want to test the presence of ketone, the very famous test that is called as your iodoform test, the ketones can undergo. It will give you yellow precipitate because of the formation of iodoform. It gives yellow precipitate because of the formation of iodoform. But the condition here is, this test is given only by your methyl ketone. That is, one of the R in ketone should be a methyl group, and also by ethanol, as it is going to contain the methyl group. in this aldehyde, it will react with I2 in presence of your NaOH. So in this, what we say is three hydrogens are substituted by iodine. So iodoform is a test which is given by your ketones, but aldehyde does not give the test of your iodoform. Hence, it becomes important to find out that what are all the tests which aldehyde gives but ketone does not. So that method we can use in order to find out the aldehyde as well as the ketone. And next we can talk about the isomerism. What are all the isomerism which aldehyde can show but not your ketones. So isomerism, when we are saying, these are all the isomerism which an aldehyde as well as ketone can show, that is your chain isomerism, position isomerism, metamerism and functional isomerism. Metamerism, functional isomerism and your chain isomerism. So there are different isomerism which can be shown by your aldehyde as well as ketone. And most important part is, what are all the methods which we are using in order to prepare your aldehyde as well as your ketone. But we should remember that there are certain common methods which can be used in order to prepare aldehyde and ketone. That is oxidation of alcohols. When we are talking about oxidation of alcohol, this can be prepared from oxidation of alcohol by using an oxidizing agent like your potassium dichromate, or we can even use your Collins reagent. So here, when the case that is in, also we need a poison in order to stop its aldehydic stage, but all of them are a good oxidizing agent. So from tertiary alcohol we can't get aldehyde from tertiary alcohol, as you will not have your alpha hydrogen. We will not have alpha hydrogen. So when we say propanol, and this is undergoing oxidation, it will give you an aldehyde. But when we say butanol, that is your 2-butanol, when this is undergoing oxidation, it will give you ketone. And tertiary, it will not show. So primary, it will give you an aldehyde. Secondary, it will give you an ketone. And tertiary, since there is no alpha hydrogen, it will not give you aldehyde. And the second method, we can say it as method of preparation, is from carboxylic acid. When we say carboxylic acid, how do we get? So catalytic decomposition of your carboxylic acid in presence of magnesium oxide, in presence of your manganese oxide, it will give you carbon dioxide plus water plus methanol. For example, if I take methanoic acid, HeuOH, and if that is reacting plus your HCOOH, that will give you, in presence of manganese oxide, as your carbon dioxide plus your H2O plus your aldehyde, formaldehyde, or we can say it as your methanol. Even methanoic acid, when it is reacting with ethanoic acid, it will give us an aldehyde, that is your ethanol. So there are different methods which we can use. Even we can prepare aldehyde from acid hydration of your alkyls. So when I say ethyne plus water in presence of H2SO4 and HgSO4, it will give us ethanol. And when we are using a proper reagent, it can give us an aldehyde, that is your ethanol. So there are different methods which we are using in order to prepare your aldehyde and ketone. And what are all the reactions which an aldehyde and ketone can undergo? So when we say reduction of your aldehyde and ketone, the major product which is being formed on reduction is alcohol. The major product which is being formed on reduction is alcohol. Aldehyde will give us primary alcohol and ketones will give us secondary alcohol. And if we say a reduction that is called as Clemmensen reduction, in which aldehyde and we are using zinc in presence of, if I take an aldehyde, for example CH3CHO ethanol, and this we try to reduce it in presence of zinc and HCl, it will give us ethane, CH3CH, or it can give you an ethane plus water. So this concept or this process of reduction of an aldehyde to an alkane, we call the name as Clemmensen reduction. And do focus the naming reactions in three chapters of your NEET syllabus, that is alcohol, phenol and ether, aldehyde, ketone and carboxylic acid, and amines. That is very, very important to focus on it. And next we say another one reduction which it can undergo is named as Wolff-Kishner reduction. In this actually an aldehyde is reacted with hydrazine. An aldehyde is reacted with hydrazine, that is CH3CHO plus hydrazine is H2NNH2. This will give us hydrazone. This can give us hydrazone. And when this is reacting, this hydrazone reacts with glycerol in presence of KOH, it will give us ethane plus nitrogen. It will give us ethane plus nitrogen. So this is very important. You can also get it from your aromatic ketone, that is acetophenone. When it is reacting with hydrazine, it can give you ethyl benzene. It can give us ethyl benzene. So there are different methods, or we can say there are different reduction of your aldehyde and ketone which will help you in getting different products. And there are different methods, same we can use as a method of preparation of your aldehyde, that is from acid chloride we can prepare aldehyde, and that reaction name is Rosenmund reaction. So there are different methods which can be used for preparation of aldehyde. But when we talk about the chemical properties of aldehyde, we have certain reactions, and the most famous reaction we say it as aldol condensation. In aldol condensation, if we take two molecules of aldehyde and they will be condensed, the product which is obtained is a compound with aldehyde and alcoholic group, and these reactions are given by compound that should have alpha carbon atom. It should have alpha carbon atom. So there are possibility of self aldol condensation, that is you can take two molecules of your ethanol and it can undergo condensation, or we can have as cross aldol condensation where you can take two different molecules, that is it can be ethanol and propanol, and that can undergo condensation. So in aldol condensation two possibilities are there, either it can be self or it can be cross. And the next reaction which we say is Cannizzaro reaction. This is basically shown by those which do not have alpha hydrogen, and in this case you will get two products formed, that is your acid and an alcohol. Two products are being formed, acid and alcohol. For example, if we take methanol is reacting with methanol in presence of concentrated potassium hydroxide, it will give you methanol and potassium salt of carboxylic acid. It will give giving us potassium salt of carboxylic acid. This is also very famous or very important reaction, that is Cannizzaro reaction. We can also say that halogenation reaction, in which you are having alpha hydrogen will be substituted by halogen and we can get a product accordingly. So that is also possible. So if we say halogenation, we can say that benzaldehyde, when it is reacting with chlorine, it can give, in presence of aluminium chloride, it can give us chlorobenzaldehyde. For example, we can say benzaldehyde, and this is reacting with chlorine, in presence of AlCl3, it can give you chlorobenzaldehyde, that is CHO will be here and you will have a chlorine. So we can say it is giving us 3-chlorobenzaldehyde. So it can, and halogenation can be undergone by ketone also. The only thing is it will give you chloroacetophenone. Or so when acetophenone is reacting with chlorine, it can give us chloroacetophenone. So same like it is halogenation, it can undergo your nitration, it can undergo sulfonation. So there are different reactions which it can undergo. So we can say that aldehyde and ketones are generally prepared by your oxidation of primary and secondary alcohol. And yes, of course, it is methanol is actually a gas at room temperature, and acetophenone is hypnotic, that is it is being used as a drug for sleeping, or it is, and filling solution, when we say it is a test or it is a mixture of your solution A and B in the ratio 1:1. And next, let us come back to our carboxylic acid, the second part of the chapter. Carboxylic acid is nothing but, you can say that aliphatic carboxylic acids up to 9 carbon atoms are colorless liquid at room temperature and with unpleasant odor, and the higher acids are like wax-like solids. They are wax-like. So the lower carboxylic acids are freely miscible with, they are freely miscible with water due to the presence of your intermolecular hydrogen bonding. It is freely miscible for, because with water due to the presence of intermolecular hydrogen bonding. And the boiling point of your aldehyde and ketones are always higher than the hydrocarbons. So when we say carboxylic acid, it can be general structure of our carboxylic acid is simple. We can say that it is RCOOH. So this we call it as our aliphatic carboxylic acid. And the same way you have RCOOH, that is, it is called as our aromatic carboxylic acid. And general methods of preparation of carboxylic acid is, it's a well-known fact that it can be prepared by oxidation or hydrolysis method. So when we say oxidation, it can be prepared by oxidation from alcohols. That is alkaline KMnO4 or chromium CrO3, that is in H2O. It can be used as an oxidizing agent and we can prepare carboxylic acid. For example, as we discussed, we can say we are taking alcohol CH3CH2OH. If this is undergoing oxidation, it will first give you aldehyde, that is CH3CHO, and further on oxidation, it can give us carboxylic acid, that is CH3COOH. So we are getting an ethanoic acid. So this can be used as a method of preparation of an carboxylic acid. We can also prepare carboxylic acid by oxidation of an aldehyde and ketone. This can also be oxidized by the, in the presence of an oxidizing agent like alkaline potassium permanganate. Or we can also prepare carboxylic acid from that is hydrolysis of your nitriles. Hydrolysis of your nitriles. Suppose if I say cyanide or nitriles, that is your RCN, if it is undergoing hydrolysis, it will give us an amide group, that is RCONH2, and on further hydrolysis, it will give us acid, that is, as it can give us a acid, that is your carboxylic acid. So it is possible that we can take it as your propnitrile, which will give you an amide group, and then it will give you a propionic acid. We can also prepare carboxylic acid from using the well-known method, that is from Grignard reagent. This is also important that there are different methods of preparing your carboxylic acid. And when we come to the general chemical properties of your carboxylic acid, so before we come into the chemical properties, we should know what are all the physical properties of carboxylic acid. So when we say existence, how the carboxylic acids are going to occur, they are actually colorless liquid with your pungent smell. And when we say the higher member, they are oily liquids, and still higher member, they will become waxy solids, as we said here, that it will be the lower member of aldehyde, the your carboxylic acid, that is aliphatic carboxylic acid, up to 9 carbon atoms are colorless liquid at room temperature with unpleasant odor, and the higher acids are wax like solids. So the lower carboxylic acid, that is whenever we talk about solubility, first 4 members are being soluble in water, that is we can say formic acid, ethanoic acid, your propionic acid, but as the number of carbon atom increases, the solubility will decrease because the size of your non-polar group will increase. So solubility of smaller member is because of the presence of hydrogen bond. The solubility of smaller member is because of the presence of hydrogen bond. And when we say about boiling point is basically considered to be higher because you are having hydrogen bond. We have the presence of hydrogen bond. So that is why we say the lower carboxylic acids are freely miscible with your water due to the presence of your intermolecular hydrogen bonding with your H2O. This is because of the presence of H2O bonding. And in the same way, when we talk about the boiling point, it becomes the same, that it is an unusual behavior. Whichever is having odd number of carbon atom, they will have lower melting point and high melting point with even number of carbon atom, and this is existing because of your symmetrical structure. This is existing because the unusual behavior is existing because of the unsymmetrical structure. So when we say about the chemical properties, what are all the chemical properties of carboxylic acid? So carboxylic acid, main we can say that it will show 4 or reaction, that is reaction due to hydrogen atom of carboxylic acid, reaction due to hydrogen atom of your carboxylic acid. So why we say reaction due to, so main 4 type reaction, if we talk about carboxylic acid, the reaction occurs because of hydrogen atom of carboxylic acid, and this property is actually showing you the acidic character of the carboxylic acid. This property basically tells us about the acidic character of the carboxylic acid. So based on it, if we try to talk about the acidic character, then the Arrhenius acid, that is Bronsted concept, carboxylic acid is regarded as an acidic. It is acidic in nature. So when we try to say which acid is more stronger, which acid is weaker. So it will be totally dependent on the value of the Ka. Higher the value of Ka, stronger will be the acid. Higher the value of your pKa, weaker will be the acid. So the total depends upon the strength. And when we say the reactions which is going to involve the COOH group, when we are talking about the reaction with your COOH group and the reaction of carboxylic acid with our salt of calcium, reaction of our acid with salt of calcium, it can also react with metals, it can undergo a reduction reaction. So there are possibility that it can also have the reaction with the help of your OH group. In this carboxylic acid with compounds like it can react with phosphorus pentachloride or phosphorus trichloride, and it can give you the product as your ethanoid chloride or ethovinyl chloride. So it is depending. But the most important is the esterification reaction. Esterification, that is whenever an alcohol and carboxylic acid and alcohol plus carboxylic acid, that is RCOOH, if it is reacting in presence of your H2SO4, it will give you RCOOR plus your H2O, and this is nothing but an ester, and this reaction is called as esterification. It can also help you, or a carboxylic acid can react with ammonia in order to give us benzamide. That is, if I say phthalic acid, if it is phthalic acid and it is going to react with ammonia, it can give us benzamide. So there are different reactions which a carboxylic acid can undergo. If we are talking about carboxylic acid or reaction of carboxylic salt of calcium, we can say that it will help in the formation of calcium carbonate and aldehyde. Reduction, it can undergo partial reduction as well as your complete reduction. So when we are saying reduction reaction, there are possibility that the acids can undergo partial reduction as well as your complete reduction. So when we say partial, the acids on reduction in presence of your reducing agent, that is lithium aluminium hydride. So from carboxylic acid, if it is being reduced in presence of lithium aluminium hydride, it will land up with the product, that is your RCOOH, that is your alcohol. It can also undergo, that is ethanoic acid, if we take for example, then it will give us a ethanol if it is. So when carboxylic acid is undergoing partial reduction, it is giving us alcohol. But when it is undergoing complete reduction, that is your second category of reduction, if it is undergoing complete reduction, it is carried out and it will form alkane. But the catalyst which we have to use is red phosphorus. If we are using red phosphorus as the catalyst for carboxylic acid to reduce, the product we get is alkane. So these are all the different chemical reactions which a carboxylic acid can undergo. And there are different special reactions which a carboxylic acid can also undergo. That is, as usual, it is nitration, sulfonation, your bromination. So these are all the different reactions which a carboxylic acid can undergo. But when we talk about the uses of carboxylic acid, that is, methanoic acid is being used as a coagulating agent in rubber industry. But when we talk about benzoic acid, it is used as an antiseptic in your perfumery. Ethanoic acid, it is being used as a solvent and also in cooking because we are using vinegar. working as your vinegar. So there are different applications of your carboxylic acid, and there are different reagent. That is, suppose if I say Schiff's reagent, it is nothing but an aqueous solution of magenta or your pink colored roseline hydrochloride. And when we are talking about certain important reaction, one important reaction is your Cannizzaro reaction and aldehyde which do not have any alpha hydrogen atom. I stress, which do not have any alpha hydrogen atom, will undergo self-oxidation and reduction. That is your disproportionation reaction on treatment of your concentrated alkali. And when we say as your Nobegonal reaction, this is going to involve condensation between your active methylene group and your carbonyl group in presence of a base. And glacial acid, it is completely a pure acid, and this is representing the solid state of our acetic acid. So among carboxylic acid, when we say formic acid is the only acid that will act as a reducing agent. Among all the carboxylic acid, formic acid is the one which is being used as a reducing agent. So based on the concept wise and the analysis, this is what we are having in aldehyde, ketone and carboxylic acid. I repeat, the naming reactions are very, very important from this chapter in exam point of view. So based on our understanding, let us try taking a test and evaluate ourselves. So here you are having different subjects available. If you click on chemistry, we are having here test with chapter wise test, and each bubble represents a test. If you see the color, different colors, green color indicates that the test is already taken. Blue, it is yet to be taken. It is in progress. Yellow, it is yet to be taken. And R is a random test. So we are having each chapter has n number of tests, and the number of tests depends upon the weightage of the chapter. So today we are going to take the test from our aldehyde, ketone and carboxylic acid. So here the reaction CH3COCH3, which reaction is represented by the given option. So when we say it as CH3COCH3 and it is giving you a product, what type of reaction it is? So it is a, obviously by looking at the reaction, we could say that it is a reduction reaction. That is, our Clemmensen reduction will actually allow deoxygenation of your aldehyde or ketone, which will help you to produce your relative or corresponding hydrocarbon. Hence, our option should be Clemmensen reduction. Option C. Let us save that and go to next. Which of the following is expected to have maximum enol content in your ethanol? Maximum enol content, when we say it is maximum enol content, will be because of two carbonyl group being attached to the CH2 group. So when we expand the structure, when we try to expand the structure of the given option, we can say that the structure should be CH3C double bond O single bond CH2 C double bond O CH3. Hence, it is important that we are having two carbonyl group to your CH2. So from the given option, if we see, the option A should be the right option. So let us save that and go to next question. Which of the following is an example of aldol condensation? As we spoke now, aldol condensation, your formaldehyde and benzaldehyde. Here we have mentioned it is do not have any alpha hydrogen atom. So when it this is not having alpha hydrogen atom, that is formaldehyde and benzaldehyde will lack alpha hydrogen atom, so they cannot undergo aldol condensation. That is, they can undergo Cannizzaro reaction. But when we are saying as your CH3COCH3, so this will have alpha hydrogen. That means it can undergo aldol condensation. I repeat, if they do not have alpha hydrogen atom, that will undergo Cannizzaro reaction. And if they have alpha hydrogen atom, they will undergo aldol condensation. So here the option should be your C, because it should have. Hence our option C is correct. Let us save that and go to next. In the Cannizzaro reaction given, the slowest step is, in Cannizzaro reaction we have to find out the slowest step. So slowest step in Cannizzaro reaction will always be the transfer of your hydride to the carbonyl group, because the hydride ion is being directly transferred from one molecule to the aldehyde and to the other and does not become free in the solution. So the transfer of hydride to the carbonyl group is considered to be the slowest step in your Cannizzaro reaction. Let us save that and go to next. The Cannizzaro reaction is not given by, as we discussed, which do not have alpha hydrogen atom will undergo Cannizzaro reaction. Hence, from the given option, we have to check which does not have an alpha hydrogen atom. So it's of course that here itself it is mentioned that aldehyde which do not undergo. So from the given option, it be checked which is not having the alpha hydrogen atom. So that will show you the Cannizzaro reaction. From the given option, we could say that your ABC. So formaldehyde will not have your alpha hydrogen atom. So option D should be the right answer. Let us save that. Which of the following statement regarding aldehyde is not correct? Here the question is, it should be not correct. So the first option, say the addition reaction occurring across the C double bond O bond is nucleophilic type. Double bond O is your nucleophilic type. Second one is the addition reaction occurring is electrophilic type. Third option says about aldehyde undergo addition reaction more readily than ketone, and the fourth option. So when we are having the questions of this type, that which is right and which is wrong, we should always focus the way that omitting the option will be the best method of attempting the test. Omitting the option will be the best method of attempting the test. So the addition reaction occurring across your C double bond O is actually nucleophilic type, but it will not be electrophilic. Hence we can say that option D is correct. That is, according to the statement, it is not correct because it will undergo nucleophilic type, not electrophilic. Let us save that and go to next. Which of the following does not undergo aldol condensation? Which of the following does not undergo aldol? So benzaldehyde will not undergo aldol condensation because it will not have alpha hydrogen. So benzaldehyde, option B. Let us save that and go to next. If we look at the reaction, it is converted to, so what is the catalyst being used, or what is the reagent it is being used for the following option? So in order to do, or CH for the above conversion, we can say that it is converted to your CH3MgI to your H3O+, and further it will give you H2SO4. On heating, it will give us HBr and R2O2. So option D should be correct. Let us save that and go to next. When we are looking at this reaction, what should be the product? What should be the product for the given reaction? So the product form should be your, because the reaction is known as your pyrrole rearrangement, and in this reaction actually a phenyl group will be migrated in preference to your methyl group, and the compound formed will be, it will be simple, the compound which is being formed, it can be as your PH, C, PH, and here you will have CH3, C, double bond O, CH3. This would be the just a replacement, or we can say that the phenyl group will be migrated in preference to your methyl group. Hence, from the given option, we could say that our option, let us check, it should be our B option is correct. So let us save that and go to next. The haloform reaction is not shown by the compound. The haloform reaction is not shown by the compound. So from the given option, compounds which will give haloform test should contain, it must have the content as your structure as CH3, single bond C, double bond O. Hence we can say that from the given option, your A not possible because it does not have C double bond O. This one it is having A, B and D will actually give you haloform, and the one which cannot be shown is your option C. So let us save that and go to next. The reduction at an acetone with magnesium amalgam followed by hydrolysis will produce. It is a reduction of your ketone. So what happens when a ketone is undergoing reduction? Pinacole may be prepared whenever your acetone or when a ketone with magnesium amalgam is being reduced. So the product should be your option C, because this is the structure of your pinacole. So let us save that and go to next. Which of the following species is an intermediate in the reactions shown below? Which is the intermediate in the reaction shown below? So it is a well-known fact that above reaction, it is nothing but your aldol condensation, and in this reaction you are using a base, that is your NaOH, which will take actually your OC hydrogen to give you the product as your CH3CH, C double bond O, H. It will take up that bond and it will replace. So option D should be our intermediate product, and finally it will give you the product mentioned, as this has to be the complete product. So we can save that and go to next. The correct order of nucleophilic addition across RC double bond O of your RCOR, RCHO and your ARCHO. So always remember, aliphatic aldehyde will react faster than R ketone, and aromatic aldehyde because of your steric hindrance and electronic reason. So aliphatic, aromatic and your ketones. So we can say aromatic aldehyde, ketone and then an aliphatic aldehyde. So So this should be the actual order. Let us save that and go to next. The below reaction involves what happens in the given reaction. So when we are talking about the given reaction, it is simple that you are having nucleophilic addition across your double bond here. Nucleophilic addition reaction is taking place because CN is moving and getting attached here and your bond breaks from here. So we can say that it is a nucleophilic addition reaction across the double bond is taking place. So we can say across your double bond. So option A. It is a very simple question because by visualization itself we could say that it is an addition reaction. Let us save that and go to next. In the reaction we have to find out what is the product Y. What is the product Y? So when we say product in this reaction, the formation of your X first, it is going to involve the addition of your N to OH, and then conversion of your X will get converted to your Y, and this is called as Beckmann rearrangement. It is called as your Beckmann rearrangement, and hence it's very simple that if you do that rearrangement, you can get this to be as your product. That is your option C. So let us save that and go to next. Since we have completed all the 15 questions, let us end the test and see how many we have done right and wrong. I know one question wantedly I have done it wrong so that I can explain you how to check that. Your question number 5 is indicated red in color because it is a wrong question. That is, we have given the wrong answer, and green one indicates that all the answers which we have done is right. But still, if we have gone wrong, if you click on the question, it will give you the right answer with a proper explanation about it. The Kanizaro reaction is not given by the one. Propanol will have two alpha hydrogen. That is why it will not undergo Kanizaro reaction, because Kanizaro reaction will be undergone only if they do not have alpha hydrogen. Hence, option B should be the right answer. So in this way, you can get an explanation of the question answer if you have gone wrong, and there is no hard and fast rule that you need to take only one time the test. The test can be taken n number of times unless and until you are confident on that particular chapter as well as the test and all the question. That's all we have for today's session. If you have any doubts, you can reach out to us with the help of ask feature available here, and also you can post your question on Telegram chat application. But in case if you need any additional help from any of the Class 6 tutor for the subject physics, chemistry, biology, you can reach out to Class 6 management for one-to-one tutoring. Thank you students. We'll catch you up tomorrow again with a new chapter.